Good morning, students. Today in this lecture we will see the next point, that is a properties of element. See, just to recall in last lecture what we discuss or what we learn. Okay, see here, the first properties of element, that is an element cannot be broken down into a simple substance by any physical and chemical method. Means element, you know that element, it is made up of only one kind of atom. Okay, so if you will try to break the element any physical or chemical method, it cannot be broken down into a simpler substances. Okay, for example, suppose you take one a gold, okay, gold, now gold ring or anything, and just you try to break it down, okay, with the help of any physical and chemical. See, we cannot break down into any other substances. Means if you will try to break the gold atom, then you will get at last the gold atom only. For example, see here, suppose this is one piece of gold, okay, and it contains so many atoms. Okay, atoms, if you will try to break down, now suppose here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 atoms are there. If you will try to break down, then okay, what you will get? You will get the 5 atoms of gold only. Okay, again you will try to break it, you will get the 4 atoms of same similar element, that is gold. Okay, again if you will try to break it, you will get the 2 atoms of gold. And even again if you will see do the same process, you will get at last the one smallest unit of atom. Okay, means if you are breaking the gold and you will get the silver, no, it will not happen. If you will try to break it down into any physical and chemical method, you will get the gold element only. Okay, this is the one example. So any element, just I given the example of gold, any means carbon. Okay, if you will try to hammer to the carbon, you will get at last the same piece of carbon only. Okay, but it is in a smaller size. Okay, see here the picture, it is given. Now the next point, it is, see, each element consists of only one kind of atom. Okay, this already we have discussed. Each element means, suppose if you will take hydrogen, you will get only the one kind of element, hydrogen only. Okay, if you will take the carbon, you will get carbon. Okay, so each the element consists of only one kind of atom. One kind of atom means, for here see the example, suppose this one, this, see, the same kind of atom, maybe any, okay, maybe any element, but it is the same kind of atom. So each element consists of only one kind of atom. This is very important. Now see, an element can exist either in the atomic form or molecular form. Means an element, any element, it will be exist either in the atomic form or molecular form. Now atomic form, for example, see silver ring. Okay, picture it is given. This silver ring is exist in atomic form. Means all the atoms of silver are arranged like this. See here, I drawn some atoms. Okay, and oxygen gas. Do you know oxygen gas? And you know that molecules means what? When one or more than one atoms combines together, it form a molecule. See here, now this is one atom, this one is one atom, so it is a one molecule. So it is in the molecular form. So oxygen gas, it is in a molecular form. See here, two atom of oxygen, two atom of oxygen, two atom, means it is the in the form of molecular form. So it is known as a molecular form, and this one is known as a atomic form. So the what is the third property of an element? An element can exist either in the atomic form or molecular form. okay. So these the some properties of an element, okay. Do you understand element means what? See, in the last lecture I have given some notes to you and I told to write down in your chemistry notebook. In that the list it was given, element list, first 20 elements list it is given for you, okay. Just read that, all the elements names, and in front of that the symbol it is given. So in the next lecture we are going to see elements name, okay. So today we will stop here. Thank you.